Most beginners will probably use visual programming to learn how to code. For students who encounter coding for the first time, visual programming is simple, readable, and very straightforward. However, you might find your students craving for a new challenge after a few visual programming projects. How can I make my code more organized? How can I reuse pieces of my code in other programs? How can I deal with larger programs? How can I create my own programs without being limited to these visual blocks? Visual programming can be good for absolute beginners, but after giving it a try a couple of times, text-based programming is a natural next step for anyone interested in programming and computational thinking. In this video, I will introduce you to text-based programming through Python, one of the most popular and most often used programming languages in the world. With Python in your classroom, you can create quizzes about historical events, solve math problems and create physics simulations, create games, plot geographical data, and conduct data analysis for scientific projects, and many more. It will add a new, exciting flavor to your classroom. So, what is text-based programming? In text-based programming, you have to write lines of code to make your program. You have to follow a set of rules when you build your code. This is called the syntax. As opposed to visual programming, here you have to be familiar with the rules, with the syntax of the programming language you use, and also be aware of typing errors. Python is one of the most popular programming languages nowadays. It comes in two major versions, Python 2 and Python 3. In this video, we will use Python 3.
This can be downloaded from the official website www.python.org, but there are also many online tools which allow you to run and write your code in browser without downloading anything. Today we'll use trinket.io, so let's get started. Go to the trinket.io/python3 website and you are ready to create your first project. You don't have to log in or sign up to write and run your code, but you can do so if you want to save your code. Trinket interface is very simple with two windows, left for writing code and right for executing output. There is also a menu on the left which allows us to download, share or embed our code. Let's write our first program. We'll tell computer to print hello world on the screen. For that we'll use the print function. Python has a simple syntax which is clean and readable. You don't have to use semicolon or anything similar to mark the end of a statement. You can run your program by clicking on the button play. It will print hello world on the standard output. Now let's add another line of code. In this line, we are using the variable name to store the input provided by the user. Variables are used to store values and give data to the computer for processing. These values can be of different types, such as strings, integer, lists, or boolean, which can all do different things. In Python, you decide the data type when you assign a value to your variable. Now in the next line of code, we'll print the message "Have a beautiful day" together with the name entered by the user and stored in the variable name. Notice that we haven't closed our message in double quotes. We can use either single or double quotes to print our message. For printing variable value on the screen, we'll just put variable name inside parentheses without quotes. In Python, you can use all the basic programming statements that you already know from scratch or another visual programming language, like conditionals for making decisions, loops to repeat blocks of code, functions, and so on. To group a block of instructions, indentation is used. Notice that the if statement ends with a colon. It separates the header of the statement from the body. All the indented lines after the colon belong to the same block of code. It is standard in Python to use force spacing for indenting. You'll use either tab or space to indent your code. Same would be applied with using loops. Python has two loop comments, for and while. For loop is used to iterating over a sequence like list or strings, while the while loop will execute blocks of code as long as the condition is met. There is, of course, much more that you can do in Python. Python has a large standard library which offers a wide range of modules, functions, and built-in methods. This is where the real fun begins. By using the Python standard library, there will be no end to your creativity. It is a collection of pre-built code of commonly used commands used to simplify programming and provide a wide range of tools for interacting with the operating system, calculating dates and times, retrieving internet data, accessing files, etc. There are many great resources to practice Python online. Let me mention some of them. Code Combat is an educational video game for learning programming concepts through game. Students can use Python, JavaScript, HTML to code. There is also a comprehensive curriculum for teachers. Code Wars is an educational community where students and teachers can train themselves through the series of challenges. Challenges are split by their difficulty and can also be filtered by programming concepts. LearningPython.org is an online interactive learning tutorial intended for everyone who wants to learn Python's beginners and advanced topics. Code Club offers some nice and interesting Python projects for kids.
If you teach languages, you can program Python to translate the vocabulary of your lesson into a different language. In history class, you can create a chatbot to ask your students about the historical events of the French Revolution. Or you can use the turtle in your art class to create a design.
By learning Python, students get the opportunity not only to see and understand how things work, but also to turn their ideas into reality and create their own programs and applications. They can experience trial and error, learning from their mistakes and how to be creative to reach their goals. When thinking about students' future and the digital literacy that everyday life and their professions will require, coding in Python is surely useful to develop and to help them develop a career in any field or industry. Considering the fact that technology is progressing day by day and new technologies create new industries, developing skills like critical thinking, problem solving and creativity is preparing students for the vast number of future jobs and roles that don't yet exist.
Now it's time to dive deeper into coding. Choose one of the activities, try it with your students, involve them in Code Week and encourage them to become creative digital makers and Python programmers. Happy Pythoning!